this marriage be as sweet as milk and honey. May it be as intoxicating as an old wine. May this marriage offer fruit and shade like a date palm. May there be no storm that your love cannot weather. May you cherish each other's dreams as your own and turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. May you brave life's mountains and miles together. May you face every challenge hand in hand and side by side and conquer all obstacles together with grace. May love and laughter fill your hearts and your home for all the days of your lives. May this marriage be as welcome as a full moon in a night sky. May the sun shine upon your bonded hearts.
Marriage enables two people to share their desires, longings, dreams and memories, to help each other through their uncertainties. It provides the support and encouragement to risk more, but also to gain more. In marriage, two people come together of their own free will. Today, this special union is an affirmation of a love and commitment to a shared future. Erica and Travis honour the importance their children, Xavier, Tamara, Rossi and Layla, have in their future life, and their marriage as a context in which their relationship can develop and grow, and in which their family can be nurtured. Travis, do you take Erica to be your lawful wedded wife, to share your life and the bonds of marriage? Will you love, honour, comfort and cherish her, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Erica, do you take Travis to be your lawful wedded husband, to share your life in the bonds of marriage? Will you love, honour, comfort and cherish him, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Gathered here today in the company of family and friends to join together Erica Jean Cossins and Travis John Hickford Page in matrimony, which is an honourable estate and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently and soberly. These two people come now to be joined. Travis met in high school and dated for a time. It would be some years before they found each other again. They have now assessed their relationship is for life. They have found each other. They love each other. They want it to last. More than that, they will it to last. To get deeper, they want to be husband and wife. Travis, I'd like to thank you all for being here today. Travis, please repeat after me. I, Travis, take you, Erica, to be my wedded wife.
I, Travis, take you, Erica, to be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love, honour and cherish.
To love, honour and cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part. This is my solemn promise to you.
Erica, please. please repeat after me. I, Erica, take you, Travis, to be my wedded husband.
I, Erica, take you, Travis, to be my wedded husband.
To heaven to hold from this day forward.
To heaven to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love, honour and cherish.
To love, honour and cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part. This is my solemn promise to you.
Erica and Travis, you have made your promises before us all. You have shown to us all your love and desire to be married, symbolised by the exchange of vows and rings. On behalf of us all, I express a wish for your continued joy and happiness. It gives me great pleasure to now pronounce you husband and wife. It gives me the greatest pleasure to introduce the newlywed Mr. and Mrs. Hickford Page.
To give either of you any advice, it's to make sure that you do have fun, be true to each other and enjoy each other's company and don't take life seriously. I'm proud of you, Trev, for where you have come, and I'm proud of both of you for what you've achieved together. I'd like everybody to just put their hands together for two amazing people.
Met each other at a younger age and they went off and did their own thing and they've come back together again, which has been really cool to see. Erica and Trav, I enjoy when I'm spending time with you, I just see all the small things you do for each other and together, and either just the day-to-day stuff, doing things for one another, getting things for one another. It says a lot about how you are together and what you think of each other and the strength of your relationship. That's just really cool to see.
15. He's at Fielding High School. He comes home from school and asks if his girlfriend, who's boarding at Fielding Ag, can come and stay for Easter. Fast forward to today, and by now you all know that Erica was that girlfriend. They have each lived a whole other lifetime in their many years apart. but they've come out the other side and here to celebrate being together again. A pretty amazing journey. So in a kind of belated back to the future moment, go ahead, you have our blessing. Make all the babies you want is what we would say if you didn't already have four, that is. Xavier, Tamara, Rossi and Layla. You are all fantastic little humans. I love being your nanny. So thank you to Erica for finding Travis again and giving us those amazing children. They bring joy to our hearts. Thank you everyone, have a great night.
Erica, although you're already very much part of our family, I suppose I can officially welcome you to the Hickford Page clan. Not many people in the world with that last name. Five now, I think. Yeah, so it's pretty cool. But no, I think you're an amazing mother to your children, my nieces and nephews, and you're very kind, caring, affectionate person. But you're also very strong-willed and gutsy and determined and passionate about life and. These are a lot of the qualities I think that Travis sees in you as well, so it's pretty obvious that you guys love each other very much. And I couldn't be happier for you both. Very cool. So I'll just finish with a toast. Here's to the groom, the bride so fair. Here's to the bride with a groom so rare. To Travis and Erica and a lifetime of happy marriage, full of laughter and love and all that stuff. I love you guys. Cheers, everybody. Thank you. Enjoy the party.
I'd like to thank the Hickford and Page families. Thank you for your names. I'll do my best to conduct myself with the dignity and honour that your legacies deserve. I love that each of you are here today to see me become one of you. Thanks to our parents. The things that you've done for us are too numerous to name here, but we love you and appreciate all that you've done for us. And you're the greatest mother-in-law that I could ever wish for, and I say that with great sincerity. Dave, thank you for your patience and generosity. John and Monica, it's been nice to get to know you better over the last year or so. The children all adore you, and so do we. My mother has shown me the value of working hard and developing fortitude. Thank you for being such a wonderful example of what being a good mother and a strong woman looks like. Greg married Mum when I was 17. He's such an important part of our family. If my father was here with us today, I know he'd be stoked that Mum chose such a wonderful man to give love, support and advice to her children. I wish that you'd come into our lives soon. Trav, I met you when I was 12 and a piece of me have loved you almost as long. I came back into your life as a package deal and I love that you're part of our children. I love the family that we've grown together and I love you. You grew into a man with a depth of character and strong convictions. I'm proud of who you are, and I'm proud to be your wife.
My amazing wife, Erica. Doesn't she look beautiful tonight? I'd like to thank Erica's parents, Greg and Karen, for raising and always continuing to raise such a wonderful person. Thank you for being there during the tough times and to celebrate the good ones as well. Whether that's giving us a hand when we need it or lending an ear, no matter how chewed it may get. It's an honour to be an official part of such a loving and accepting family who are always there for each other and always have each other's back. I'd also like to thank my parents for your love and support and for sticking by me and seeing the good, even though I've kept you up countless nights and wondering whether or not I was still alive due to another poorly calculated decision on my part. When I think about all the things my family and friends have done for me, it would be impossible to describe them all in one speech. Thank you all from the bottom of my heart. When I think about how much I love my wife and how much she means to me, it seems as if an entire lifetime of kind words wouldn't be enough to describe it. La last Christmas, Erica requested that I write her a letter. I hadn't written a letter since we both temporarily parted ways at high school. This task seemed a little bit daunting, as did writing the speech. I'm going to read this letter to you now, though it's the slightly edited version. It still comes from the heart. Dear beautiful, Merry Christmas. Another year has flown by, getting faster and faster each time around, as we knew they would. Even when we would call each other at high school and talk for hours on end, followed by a very long-winded to-ing and fro-ing of the know-you hang-ups, then there never seems to be enough grains of sand in the hourglass. I'm surprised I've managed to find even enough time to write you this letter. I guess it shows that anything's possible if you make time for it. This year, you gave me a daughter, one of the greatest gifts a man could ever hope for. To me, she is perfect, would suit me perfectly, because her mother is perfect too. Layla Faye Hickford Page has taken her place at the table, and our beautiful, kind, loving family is finally complete. Well, for now, anyways. You have exceeded all my expectations, and you showed me how strong you are in many ways. The way you coped and hung in there with one of the worst pregnancies of all time, and still managed to be available as a loving parent and partner, is truly admirable. This year has been testing for us both at times, to say the least. With me starting full-time dairy farming, doing long days, and you doing basically everything else. You've come a long way since we first met up again. You have four amazing children. They're amazing because of the time, love, energy, kindness, and patience you put into them. Credit where credit is due, they're amazing because of you. I guess I just hope that the tired, cranky, sore old veteran farmer doesn't rub off on them too much. You've done an epic job of looking after our family. You've filled our hearts with warm love, our bellies with delicious warm food, our drawers with warm clean clothes. Thank you for going into battle every day to make sure our home is a place of love and kindness, happiness and laughter. If medals were given to those who deserve them, there would surely be one for you. You have no problem telling me when it's time to pull my head in. This I admire about you. It takes grit for a woman to tell a headstrong veteran that his way of life could also do with a few minor improvements. Every day I look at you, you somehow seem even more beautiful. I guess there's some benefits to marrying a guy with a head injury. I'm still truly the luckiest man I know, and I have you to thank for that. Anyways, it's getting late, and it's about time that I make an attempt of summing it all up. You are my sunny tropical island in a sea of stormy chaos. We're all blessed to have you in our lives. Thank you for all the things you do for us, especially the ones we don't notice. You're beautiful, you're kind, you're smart, occasionally funny, often witty, a hard worker, a good friend, a caring person, a great mother, and a devoted partner. I'm very proud that one day, if I continue to be lucky, you will be my wife. You are very much loved by all of us. I love you.
Please. Toast to Erica and Travis.